Hi everyone. I said I was going to be doing a very different type of video this week, and I wasn't joking. It is Independent Booksellers Week is approaching, and we all love bookshops. We all love books, and the Booksellers Association have sent me 10 questions to celebrate the 10th anniversary of Independent Booksellers Week, and we're going to start a tag. We're going to see how many other YouTubers and vloggers we can get to answer these questions, which are to celebrate books and bookshops, and just sort of share some of our thoughts and memories and things like that. So here we go. 10 questions, starting with... Right, so what books are currently in my bag? I've actually brought the books out of my bag. Here we go. I've got two books in my bag at the moment because I decided that the first one of them here is Swan's Way, which is the first volume of Proust's Search for Lost Time. And because I was worried that I might sort of, you know, find this a bit heavy going or a bit tough, I thought I might have another read on the go at the same time, which I sometimes do. So what I have here also is The Fortunes by Peter Ho Davis, which is a proof copy here. Peter Ho Davis wrote a book called The Welsh Girl a few years ago, which I really, really enjoyed. And this is his new novel, so I really wanted to read where he had gone next. So those are the two books that are currently in my bag. Now, the last great book I read, that's really hard because I read really good books all the time. So if we're going to be really tough and we're going to say great, it's got to be a truly great book, one that will really last. I think the last great book I read was probably When Breath Becomes Air by Paul Kalanithi, because when we talk about a great book, that book really affected me whilst I was reading it. And it's really affected me after I've finished reading it, and I keep talking to other people about it, and they keep talking to me about it. It's an absolutely stunning book. I'll put a link to my video where I talk about that book, but it's his memoir about dealing with a life-ending diagnosis of cancer, and his examination of what it means to live a good life, the story is picked up by his widow because he dies in the course of writing the book, and both of their writing is fantastic. It's sort of a life-changing book. So if we talk about great books, I'd definitely say that that's definitely up there. What book have I gifted the most? That is really hard. I don't tend to gift the same book, actually. I tend to really try to give people the right book, if you see what I mean. And so each person is individual, and so I'll always try and find exactly the right book for the right person. I do remember there's a book called If Nobody Speaks of Remarkable Things by John McGregor, which is brilliant. And I loved that book so much that I do remember buying at least two or three copies of that and giving it to other people. And then there's that weird thing when you give a book to somebody else, so that if they don't like it as much as you, it's really painful. And that slightly happened with that book. I'd had such a personal reaction to it. In fact, I've just mentioned When Breath Becomes Air, which was a book that did make me cry when I read it, which hardly ever happens to me. And there are only two other books that I can think of that did that to me, and If Nobody Speaks of Remarkable Things is one of them. I think it's an amazing book. I think John McGregor is a brilliant writer. So, yeah, that's a book that I've probably gifted the most, having bought only about two or three copies of it for other people. My favourite independent bookshop. This is really, it's quite a mean question because there are so many that I love. I'll pick my favourite based on the fact that I love going there because, the bookshop is Goldsborough Books in London. And it's my favourite, I think, because the owner, David Headley, I would count as a friend of mine. I hope you feel the same way, David. I just like going there and talking to him about books. About books that we've both read, books that one or other of us has read. We like to trade opinions about stuff. We have very, very different taste, which is why I love talking to him about books, because we're never kind of talking about the same thing. So I always learn something there. And it's a bookshop that specialises in signed modern first editions. And I love collecting books, and I love the idea of having lovely signed first editions all over the place. Not that I can afford them anymore. And so I like to go there and have a look, if not to buy. But David is a brilliant, brilliant man, and I love chatting to him about books. So I would say that's probably my favourite. Ooh, okay, so favourite book recommended by a bookseller or YouTuber. I think this was actually not recommended to me. It was recommended to my dad by a bookseller. So the bookseller was Crockett and Powell, which is a bookshop that used to exist in Waterloo in London. I'm afraid it doesn't exist anymore, but I know that Crockett and Powell are both still out there. Hello. And they recommended a book called House of Leaves by Mark Z. Danielewski to my dad. And my dad then mentioned it to me, and I went out and sought a copy. And that book is amazing. It is one of the only books I've ever read that actually terrified me, that made me scared whilst reading. It is about a man who, whilst he's carrying out some kind of renovations on his house and is doing various measuring of rooms, realises that the internal measurements of his house are bigger than the external measurements, which doesn't make any sense, of course. And so he begins to investigate. And his investigations run parallel to a sort of journal which is being read. And there's sort of like three metafictional parts to the book. And he ends up discovering this kind of like a labyrinth. I don't know how to describe it, really. There is this space in his house that shouldn't be there. And as you're reading, the text kind of breaks apart. And there are points where you are scared to turn the page because there might literally be a monster kind of on the next page. Amazing, amazing book. One that I would never have read if I hadn't been told about it by a bookseller, which is why booksellers rock. Favourite bookshop memory. Okay, this is really quite hard. The thing that's popped into my head is when I was training to be an actor many years ago. In fact, it's before I was training to be an actor, I had a book called About Acting by an actor called Peter Barkworth. And I remember seeing that he was going to be doing a sort of a bookshop opening near where I was going to school. In fact, exactly where I was going to school. So I went to this opening to ask whether he would sign my copy of his book. And he did much more than sign it. We stood and we had a chat, and he was so warm and lovely and encouraging. And he wrote a really nice thing inside my book. And he's sadly passed away now. But I suppose, yeah, that's one of my favourite bookshop memories, was being in this lovely place surrounded by books, but having this rather nice experience. And this can happen, of course, now. There are so many events in bookshops, book signings and talks and all the rest of it. There is a chance to get out there and to meet authors. And if there are authors that you really like, you know, sometimes it's really worth doing because you can have a chance to sort of trade a few words, and it can really help. What do bookshops mean to me, and what do I love about them? I'm not the only one. I just love walking around bookshops. I suppose, particularly in London, it's really nice to have a bit of time to yourself. And if you don't get a lot of time to yourself, like me, if I ever do, one of my first thoughts is always, oh, I can have a wander around the bookshops. And I think it's just that thing, it gives you a bit of time out of the day, a time out of the hustle and bustle of living in London or working in London. There's something nice and calm and reflective about bookshops. I love looking at books. I like touching them. I like looking at book designs. I like reading bits of books. I like talking to booksellers. I like finding new recommendations, finding things I'd never heard of or thought of. I think, you know, bookshops for me are like a sort of oasis in a desert, or they're a bit of solace away from all that kind of busyness. That's what I really love about them. And the rare occasion when you can actually just sort of sit down and read a book that you've just bought in a nice comfy chair, possibly with a coffee. I love doing that because it's sort of like reclaiming a bit of time from what is, of course, nowadays a very, very busy and sort of a life where we've got all these kind of things flashing at us all the time and devices and all that sort of stuff, says the man who works in social media. But, you know, it's nice to have a little bit of, carve out a bit of peace from that and enjoy it in a bookshop. I can't think of anything better. What are the books that made me and influenced me? It's so hard when you've read so many books. Okay, so I'll be brutally honest here. So when I was young, I didn't read loads, but I do remember reading those Choose Your Own Adventure books. I loved those books, absolutely loved them. If anyone doesn't remember them or can't quite understand them, it was a book where you read a bit of a story and then you get to a point in the story where the character that you were basically controlling could either, you know, open the door on the right or open the door on the left or go down the corridor or go into the hedge or whatever it might be. And the decisions that you made would make you flick through to a different page in the book. You pick up the story, then you make another decision. And it's basically like role-playing. It's basically the precursor to a computer game because that's how old I am. This is pre-computer games. But I loved those books because you knew that the decisions you were making were affecting what would happen in the book. And that was just mind-blowing to me. I was in charge of what happened to this character. And of course, what often happened was that you fell through a pit and died, and you'd have to go back and find the right decision to make that would mean that you would end up sort of, you know, rescuing the girl and winning the day. So I love those books. So that's something that sort of formed my early experience. That's why I love computer games and interactive things now, I think. The book that sort of made me realise what books could really do was probably Anthony Burgess's A Clockwork Orange. I read it probably a bit young, although roughly the same age as the main character, Alex, in that book. But it blew my mind because the language in that book, it's written in an invented language called Nadsat, which is sort of the language that Alex and his droogs, his gang, have made up so that they can't be understood by people around them. And just seeing what language could do in that book, and the serious themes that were raised in it about freedom and society and crime and punishment and things like that, it just blew my mind. And I thought this sort of opened my eyes to what adult reading could be. And then I suppose the next development in that was probably reading books that were really helped to make me a mature and adult reader. And I think I have to take my hat off to Philip Roth for that. And I'll do a little hat tip to Dominic Drumgoole, who is a theatre director. Recently ran the Globe Theatre. He was somebody who encouraged me to read Roth along with my own dad, and I am so grateful to him for that because I absolutely love Roth. I've learnt so much from reading those books, and they have helped to sort of mature my reading as I've grown older, and I still have more to read, which is just a lovely, lovely place to be. So there you go. I think those are sort of three stages of my reading which have helped shape me as a reader. Okay, a gift for Father's Day. I'll make this very simple and easy because it's a book I've recently read, and it's called All That Man Is by David Saloy, and it is a book all about men at various stages in their life. As each chapter you go through, it looks at a man who's a little bit older than the previous one, and the writing is amazing, and it's so utterly engaged with men and indeed fathers that I think it would make a brilliant gift for dads, particularly sort of at the literary end of the spectrum. If your dad likes that kind of stuff, I think he would love it. And the book at the top of my TBR pile at the moment is this one here, The Association of Small Bombs by Karen Mahajan. I can't wait to read this book. It's got insane praise on it from people like Kevin Powers, Norman Rush, Jeff Dyer, Joshua Cohen, Rachel Kushner, Elizabeth McCracken. I mean, just amazing people saying amazing things about this book. And I think it could be really exciting. So that's next on the list. So there you go. That's it. That's the 10 questions. I'm now going to tag Vanessa, Rose and Lauren. You know who you are. You have to do the 10 questions. And then, of course, you have to tag more people yourself. And let's get this spreading. And anybody watching this, if you want to join in, you've got the 10 questions now. We would love to hear about your sort of book and bookshop memories and the things that you love. So do get involved. And most importantly, go to bookshops. Not only are they lovely because they're filled with books, they're filled with booksellers who are lovely, informed and wonderful people. So go and talk to them. They will help you find brilliant books. There you go. Enjoy.